Alright, let's just revisit where the story is here. Lieutenant Woodson says that we might be able to get, he might be able to get us past the southern radiation wall by upgrading our rad suits with medical-grade zeolite. He needs to talk it over with Captain Mercaptain first. The rumor is that God's Militia and Griffith are stockpiling zeolite. We need to get our hands on some of it. So basically, we're gonna have to go deal with the God's Militia now, those crazy people, because they have the zeolite, and because we can't talk to Mercaptain back at the Citadel in Arizona, until we put a radio tower in Griffith Park, which is apparently also where he said... Yeah, that's where they said the God's Militia is. So basically everything points to Griffith Park, where we're gonna get zeolite and a proper radio access to call back to the previous coast. I mean, not the coast, back to Arizona. And then also figure out how to pursue the zeolite, at which point we go south, past the south radiation wall, to find out, finally, what's going on with our fallen comrades. Man. I thought we were gonna rescue Angela Death, and maybe the story will still go in that direction. But I feel like our chances dropped pretty dramatically when you consider how much time has passed since we arrived in California in the first place. But hey, I got my new armor equipped, so we should be able to go past level 6 radiation up to the north. It's nice getting a little tiny bit of free. God, you have to do so many fights if you don't have outdoorsmen equipped, but I do. So we're safe right now, right? No one's health is going down? Right? I think everyone looks healthy still. So now we explore. What's that? Go away. Yay, free experience. Mysterious shrine. Why not? Hello. Admire. Someone has spray-painted graffiti on this statue. Cleric, you doji fuck gav, you micro drug, war my scrap, I kill you. Anyway, everyone gets a skill point. It was really a pleasant experience. What's over here? Just keep going? Usually the thing you get is at the end. Oh, the underworld. That seems like a change of pace. Are there gonna be NPCs around here? What are we getting involved in here? Anyone? There's currently no one here, and it's starting to look a lot like a game I had on the PlayStation 1. I think it's called like Fully Loaded. I think it's called Loaded, yeah. It was a top-down game with tile floors where you're just wailing away on everybody. Very bloody. Very bloody. And co-op. Hello. Mysterious Shrine. A plaque at the base of the shrine reads, "The Reborners. Live and die in a society that will not repeat the mistakes that led to the destruction of the world." So we got experience from admiring. Now the entire party's ready to level up. Alright. Now if I find Griffith Park and everyone starts shooting us, I can just, be, like, after that fight's over, I can call back to command and everyone gets full health again and I can continue. Because the entire... Wow. I don't know if I've ever actually gotten into a situation before where the entire roster was ready to level up. I've also never, I don't think I've ever been to a shrine location that had two. Both a skill point shrine and a inspiration shrine at the same location. Is that a thing I can interact with? That's just a car. Alright. Back to the overworld. And we are back in Overworld, California. On the far right corner, visiting shrines and whatnot. What's that? What are you?
Brother Malediction, I hear you ask. Brother Malediction, who was this Luke Samson, who was the man who we now call the Red Messiah? Who was our savior? Well, brothers and sisters, I'll tell you. 75 years ago, Luke Samson was just another man, lived right here in Hollywood. And, to be honest, he wasn't even a particularly good man. He was a scavenger, like so many are in these hard times. And known to drink and cuss and occasionally settle arguments with the help of a sledgehammer. But one night, when he was digging in the rubble of a TV station down in Gower Gulch, he stumbled upon a video cassette that was to change his life. Thinking, hoping that it was some kind of pre-apocalypse pornography, he found himself a working VCR and popped it in. It wasn't pornography, brothers and sisters. Oh, no. It was salvation. What Luke Sampson had found was the last surviving record of the wisest prophet of the pre-apocalyptic age, the great James King. Can I get a hallelujah, brothers and sisters? Have you met the Mannerites, brothers and sisters? They sure are polite, aren't they? Nicest bunch of folks you're ever likely to meet. Got a smile and a howdy-do for everyone. Yes, indeed. But polite as they are, there is a fatal flaw beneath the surface of their courtesy. A dark secret behind their sunny dispositions. And do you know what it is, brothers and sisters? That's right. They do not believe in God. Nor do they believe in sin. Oh, their civility patrols walk around, protecting the weak and defenseless from the strong and well-armed. And that's mighty nice. I'll admit that. But would those same security patrols burn a cache of pornography to stop its poison from corrupting the world? Would they forcibly separate a couple who is about to engage in unmarried sex in order to save them from sin? Would they put a homosexual out of his misery and allow him to enter the kingdom of heaven? No, they would not. They are much too polite for that. They couldn't possibly interfere where they weren't wanted. Well, they're forgetting something. They're forgetting to ask what God wanted. The business of saving souls ain't got nothing to do with politeness, brothers and sisters. We gotta show sinners the error of their ways, whether they want us to or not. So, the next time you see one of the Mannerite civility patrols, remember that they are protecting sinners and turning a blind eye to perversion. They are the devil with a smiling face. And you know what we do with the devil, don't we? That's right! We give them hell, brothers and sisters! We give them hell!
Wow! So, we had a bad run-in with the Mannerites, where we ended up shooting each other really quickly after we met them. Because they're crazy, insane, horrible, sociopathic monsters that think they're doing the right thing. And, we get one of our first proper introductions to this God's militia, and they're immediately saying, you know what the Mannerites' fatal flaw is? They don't go far enough. It's like, oh shit, we're doomed. Alright, well, we're not gonna get along. But this is Hollywood, interestingly enough. They're supposed to be in Griffith Park. I'm gonna pass on Hollywood for now and keep exploring. Oh, hello, Five. Another five wall over here. I'm gonna pass on Hollywood for now just to see. Because I don't think I have a reason to go there right now. I can check real quick. Let's see. Foxtrot, that is, yeah, Griffith Park. Denture paste is never gonna happen. I wish I could just abandon this mission to make it get off my screen. Let Angel Oracle know that Rhodey is open for trade. Nope. These two never happening. Angel Oracle, not a great time. Determine through level threat of the broad. Yeah, I basically don't have quests right now besides to go to Griffith Park. And Hollywood seems like the type of place that just is kind of important, right? So I'm sure they'll send me there for some reason at some point. So let's not obsess so much. Can't go that far. They're just gonna keep going, huh? Alright. Wanna check the health real quick to make sure it was going down or not, but it looked at the top of our health bars looked slightly like they were going down and I couldn't tell for sure. But I think this little tiny chunk of map is all there is. Okay, so this is all I gained access to was the shrine in Hollywood, so I guess Hollywood's gonna be the place to go to. Let's scout this middle part a little bit. I'm still having that weird problem where on the map, the screen keeps hitching up like this over and over again. Like, go stop, 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 go stop. I don't know what's causing that. I don't think it used to move that way. But that's just how it's been for a while. Alright, let's shut that up. Alright, we've completed our transition from visiting the Mormons to visiting the, what I'm sure is like the Spanish Inquisition practically. Let's do a quick save. Well, kind of hitched up there. Sally, put you up front. And we'll see how Hollywood treats us.
Surrender, thou Hollywood whoremasters! Thy doom has come upon thee!
Oh, Ayrton, you try. Anyway, someone was trying to get here earlier, so it seems to be like this would be a decent place to go to. Welcome to Hollywood, for sure, highlighting the many attractions and sights of Hollywood. High production values, but not a lot of substance, it would seem. Can I read that? Where is it? Oh, I forgot to sell my dumb jackets. Yeah, we can, okay. Brought to you by the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Hello, welcome to the last bastion of freedom and commerce in Southern California, and maybe the world. You might have some questions about this place, so here we go. What is Hollywood? Hollywood is a protected area of trade, business, and entertainment. We are a safe hold for those free thinkers who believe in liberty, commerce, and fun, shielding them from the madness and fanaticism that has gripped so much of the LA swamps. As such, we welcome all honest traders and seekers of pleasure, and offer your protection while you are within our walls. It's a bit of a surprise to me. When I started reading this thing, I actually thought that this thing was going to be from old Hollywood, but this is actually a new brochure of the apocalyptic Hollywood. What is the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce? The HCC is a cooperative business organization funded and democratically run by the store owners of Hollywood. Rather than each of us relying on his or her own security and taking care of the streets and structures around us on our own, we work together, pooling our resources to keep Hollywood safe and well-maintained, both inside and out. The Hollywood Safety Patrol are funded by the Chamber of Commerce and keep our streets peaceful, clean, and honest, allowing participating businesses to thrive. Additionally, the Chamber's funds cover the cost of repairing aging buildings, streets, and utilities, and protecting our common borders from the madmen outside. What rules do I need to know about? Nothing that common sense doesn't dictate to you. Trade honestly, respect the police and the chambers of commerce, and do not harm anyone or steal from anyone, and do not vandalize public or private property. Beyond that, we do not judge your habits or pleasures. As long as you do not harm, as you do no harm and your coin is good, you are free to do as you like. What is sin? As you made your way here, you may have been accosted by the so-called God's Militia, who will have warned you that merely setting foot in Hollywood, you are committing a sin, or that pleasure itself is a sin, or that even thinking about pleasure is a sin. Well, as far as the HCC is concerned, there is only one sin in this world, and that is hurting another person against their will. So look around you, and see if you see any victims here. You won't find any. Everyone is here of their own free will, doing only what they desire. Then go follow the God's Militia for a while, if you dare, and see the innocents they slaughter, and the innocents they enslave. They make up. Then make up your own mind about what sin is and who are the sinners. But really, fuck that. Stay here and enjoy yourself. It's much more fun. Signed, Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Alright. Look ahead as we pass, try not to focus on him. Someone talking about somebody? MP Boz. Anyway. Based on that brochure, if they stick to that, then the Hollywood people should be the most sane people out here, besides the people of Rhodia that we've been able to liberate also, which is a nice change of pace because everyone is freaking losing their minds, but I won't be entirely surprised if they manage to show me a reason to go back on my praise so far. Let's check out this corner over here first. Sort of hug a wall and make our way around. I find it's one of the only ways to navigate these places properly. A manhole cover the lead somewhere. Okay, we'll put a footnote on that one. Trying to focus on him. Hey now. Welcome to Hollywood, fun seekers. You look like you need some condoms. Is he some kind of cardboard cutout of a man? Or an old-fashioned song and dance man? Hello, you. That's the guy that's trying to sell condoms. He looks a lot like the guy that runs the Rangers. You wouldn't think a beard and a tutu would go together, but somehow Rat Boy makes it work. What? No? Not condoms? Pet rock then? Dolls? Directions? Snow globes? How about this one? It's got Manny's Chinese Casino being showering in tiny golden coins. What about a souvenir condom from Heidi's Hollywood Hideaway? Tell me about Heidi's. Ah, the condom. Wise choice. Here you go. What? He doesn't like talking about things, does he? He just tries to sell condoms? Holy crap, they're expensive too. Ribbed for her pleasure. How much do they prefer individually? So each, it's $75 each. Had to be a big number because it was almost $2,000 just for the individual stack. Snow globes, mistress knows best. He sells merkins? Why? Bound to pleasure for not enthusiasts? No, no, it's not. Lick and Stick Quarterly, a magazine about popsicles? No, no, it's not. Mistress Knows Best sounds Victorian. Oh, you naive child. And a vibrator. Why did you pick this up? Why? I didn't pick it up. It's in this guy's store. And why he has it is a whole other question. Try to sell my scrap. I tried to sell, junk if I have any. Alright, how about some directions? Sure, amigos, directions are free. With the purchase of any other item. So what'll it be? Condom? Snow globe? Pet rock? You, son of a bitch. He does not want- Alright, I'm gonna- Sorry folks, gotta go talk about- gotta go talk to some paying customers. Adios. There's no paying customers. You are a terrifying tutu, man. I heard someone screaming last night. Not exactly news in Hollywood. Yeah, but this was weird. It sounded like it was coming from under the street. Oh. We might want to go down there at some point. Hello, friends. Would you like to take a free compatibility test? Oh, no. Are we talking about, like, Thetans?
Hello, friends. My name is Matthias, leader of the Children of the Citadel, bringing you good news for your future. Look around you. Look at the kiosk I'm speaking from. Sad, isn't it? You live in a world of squalor, crime, and death. Now look at the world on my screen. Isn't it beautiful? So clean, so bright and polished. But it's only a dream, you say. Unattainable, impossible. Not so. It is reality. A reality that is even now under construction at our new citadel in Seal Beach. This metropolis of modern marvels could be your new home, your new perfect life. Next, look at your body. Look at you, scars and sores and grimy hands. Your rotting teeth and malnourished limbs. Feel the aches and pains of your poorly doctored injuries. Encroaching frailty of age. So tragic. Now look at me. Look at my gleaming, faultless skin. My perfect metal and plastic body that will never age, never weaken, never know pain. Again, you say, it is an unattainable dream. But am I not living proof that it is not? Become one of my children. And you too will wear skin like this. You too will never grow old or fear injury or disease. You too will become immortal. And all this, your new world, your new body, your new life, cost you nothing. Nothing but loyalty. Please, join me in Seal Beach and start living your perfect future today.
Everyone's recruiting today. All right, you guys talking to me? I'm Alex Falk of the Children of the New Citadel. Are you interested in finding out if you've got the personality to attain a brighter future? Do you want to know if you're compatible with Matthias's vision of a new world? Then take our simple test. It only takes a minute and it costs absolutely nothing. What do you say? Wait till they find out that I am a member of the Rangers. Maybe just not mention that since we've learned in the past it's bad. Yes? Excellent. We can do it right here. Are you ready? There are five questions. Question 1. Do failures in your past continue to haunt you? Yes? Like the death of Vulture? Okay, question 2. Do you get occasional muscle twitches with no outward cause? Yes, that's called having organs. Fine. Now question 3. Have you ever had a strong emotional connection to an inanimate object? Yes? Interesting. Fourth question. You're walking in the desert and you see a tortoise on its back baking in the sun. Do you turn it over or leave it as it is? You turn it over. In fact, I've done this already in this playthrough. Uh-huh. Okay, last question. Do you think that one life matters? Yes. Got it. Now let me look over your answers. Yes, very promising. Very promising indeed, friend. I think you have what it takes to be part of Matthias' golden future. Of course, before we can be certain, we need to do further tests, but I don't have the facilities to do those here. You'll have to go to New Citadel itself, which is far to the south. Alright, he's just covered in cords and just looks horrifying. What a great person. Alright, what is the golden future? Out of the Citadel shall rise the sun that will illuminate a new age of prosperity and hope. All that join Matthias in the synthesis will share that future, and we will live in peace and harmony for all eternity. Why would we want indoctrination? Did I say indoctrination? I meant education. I'm sure that's what you meant to say. Also, you forgot to answer the question. What is synthesis? The synthesis is the holy wedding of the immortal human mind and spirit to the immortal body of the machine. Only when all humanity achieves synthesis will we transcend the horrors of this world. Who's Matthias? Matthias is the Messiah of the Golden Future, he who will lead us to an eternal paradise here on Earth, and then one day to the stars. It's not like when it's just the moment people start talking about paradise and how someone's going to lead us to the Golden Future or just magical solutions for all of our problems. I'm like, all right, well, you guys are crazy. We're not going to want to ally with you because pragmatism is kind of necessary to make the world work. What is the New Citadel? The New Citadel is the headquarters of our church. It is humble now, as befits the humility of our leader, but soon it will be the most beautiful place on Earth. The place from which all hope for the future emanates. Who are the children? We are the children of the New Citadel, devotees of Matthias, and the future that he is building here. Alright, bye. Thanks, and I hope we'll visit the New Citadel.
Until I remember that his masters tried to poison all of my people.
Yeah, minor details, huh? Nanu, nanu! My philosophy, $100 shine on a $3 pair of shoes. Look at... They keep talking about not talking to that one guy as they walk by. The guy says, nanu, nanu? Why is he saying nanu, nanu? Quick, run away. Matthias is going to rant again for like 10 minutes. What's over here? It's not a huge map, but it definitely has some expanse to it. Take a look around here. Oh, that's... Oh, Los Feliz. We have spots that go to... It seems like it goes out to a different location than... Like, so this is a more expansive place than I might have thought at first, because it seems like this might be a bit like the Rail Nomads place, where there's a place within a place, if that goes somewhere. Let's go ahead and quick save before we wander on to a new place, because there's a little door over here. Drive carefully. Come back soon. Strange for such a rundown place, but the door, despite being covered in graffiti and scratches, is... heavily reinforced steel. If it wasn't propped open, you'd doubt the scrawny junkies who constantly pass through it could even budge it. Oh, what am I walking in on? Time to get worried. $10, good. First door on the left. Ooh, is this a drug trade building? Is that what we've got here? You want a room? Talk to Don. $10, okay, first door on the left. Wait, he's just sending everyone to the same room? Is that just where the deal happens? That's not money, that's a bunch of bottle caps. Come back here when you got $10. Sorry, no vacancy. No, can't observe them at all? Hey, it's got a safe back there. Is there nothing I can do here? The gate's locked. Yep, looks like this is the type of place that would come up later in some context. For now, I think it's just a place to observe. Onward. What are we going to find up here? This place is pretty expensive. Expansive and expensive.
Ranger. Over here.
Okay, it got weird. It got weird. Just another COTC information kiosk, except Matthias is talking to us from it.
Don't worry. This isn't a trap. I just want to talk to you. I want to see if we can come to some kind of understanding.
There's no understanding between us, murderer.
Ah, but you see, we're both murderers, aren't we? And we both believe our murders are justified. Just as we both feel the other's murders are heinous crimes. But what if I was to tell you that it's all been a misunderstanding? That all along, we've wanted the same thing.
You want the destruction of humanity, we want to save it. How can that be the same?
Who said I want the destruction of humanity? I want the transcendence of humanity. Look, we both want a better life for people. All we are arguing about is who has the best method. So let's compare. You want to give people a better life by catching criminals and imposing order. So let me ask you, is it working?
Of course it's working.
Really? Is there still crime? Yes. Has any police force ever stopped all crime? No. Will any amount of enforcement ever stop all crime? No. And why? Because enforcement doesn't fight the root problem, which is human need. Transcendence will.
Yes, good job. You found that a thing is imperfect in its current implementation, so you decided to just jump to a completely different model for the entire world, based on no evidence, just assuming that, yeah, it'll fix all your problems. I can say that because I have nothing to base it on. Yay. Okay, I'll bite. How will transcendence solve need?
Simple. When our minds and souls are contained in synthetic bodies, we will not need food. We will not need water. We will not need shelter. All the things that we humans rob and steal and kill each other for will be made completely obsolete. We will need the sun to power our batteries, and that's all. There will be nothing left to fight for. Everyone will have enough.
That's not how entropy works. No matter what you are, you're going to degrade in some way, and you're always going to need resources to keep that going, and there will always be eventually some form of scarcity.
Isn't that a beautiful dream? Isn't that worth fighting for?
You're pretty goddamn crazy. There's no misunderstanding. You're the enemy, and we're done here.
It's really too bad, Rangers. Had you said yes, I might have spared your friends at Ranger Citadel. Now I'm afraid there's nothing you can do to save them. We fly to Arizona in a matter of days. How will you ever live with the guilt?
Ah, we are gonna have a fight at the Ranger Citadel. I was wondering when that was gonna happen, because it's just shaped like a place where you're gonna fight in, and there's giant turrets and everything. So that makes sense. That must be the climax of this entire game, then. We establish contact here. We get past the southern radiation wall, we find Angela Death, or whatever happened down there, and then we probably go back to Arizona to do a final battle at the, Ranger Citadel, and then maybe the game ends. Oh my god, the TV's looking at me! It can do that? That's really freaky. I don't like that.
It seems you're not cut out to be the children of the Citadel. It's really too bad. Have you done as I asked? You might have spared your friends at Ranger Citadel.
I get a kick out of the fact that the only way to exit the conversation is to say goodbye, which is a weird acknowledgement that you might not want to make with a villain like that. The rock or debris along this barricade looks freshly turned, as if it has been swept away recently. Looking closer, you can see a metal panel through the cracks between the boulders. Perhaps if you could move the stones aside, you could get a better look. How did we get through? So how did we get through? Brute force? 0%! We boned. I could probably throw a grenade at it and clear that out that way. Definitely would save first just in case, just to make sure that we're not gonna accidentally aggro everybody by doing a combat action in town, but let's keep exploring Hollywood for now. This place seems like it might go on for a while. Ah! We're probably halfway done already though, because the map's generally centered on the screen, and we've already hit the right boundary over there, so the left boundary is probably going to be right under where it says local map. What's on the ground here? Oh, that's just grass. I'm like, is that like 100 rat corpses? Not quite. Shovel Knight, go! Alright. Like usual, let's go ahead and quick save before we deal with the, toaster. What's my... Ooh! More likely to succeed than fail. That's not always common. Here we go. Come on. Oh, Jesus Christ. That was extreme. There we go. What'd we get? The Walk of Fame star. In faded gold lettering, the name Tom Selleck can be made out inside a granite star. Below the text, someone has spray-painted I Heart Magnum. The things you can find around here. How the fuck do you put a Hollywood Walk of Fame star in a toaster? Oh well. None of these things should be inside a toaster. Didn't I find a dildo inside of a toaster? Most things in these toasters can't be found inside of toasters. Just like, size-wise, I mean. Obviously they wouldn't normally be there regardless. Hello. Think I can go into? Let's find out what's in here.
This is the best souvenir place ever! C'est du mer, non?
Oh, he's psyched because we just walked into a gun shop. Is this a back room? Am I supposed to be here? Oh, it looks like that might be a gun range. This actually might be the entrance. This might be how you walk in. So this might be my chance to be able to get access to weapons and ammo. Ow! I'm sorry. I didn't know what I was doing. Jeez.
This is the best place ever. C'est du mer, non?
Alright, we'll try this again. Are they going to get mad at me for walking to this door? Nope. Is there a front door? Oh, there's the front door, I think. That must be the front door, but they don't seem to be too worried. Can I talk to you? Nope, I get a talk prompt, but no talking. This must be the local gun shop. Is there really cool upgrades? Because I had to go through extra stuff to get access to this place, so there's probably even better guns here. This man is watching an old VHS tape that's labeled First Blood. Whatever that is, and it seems to have affected him deeply. A single tear rolls down his cheek.
Hello? Ah, the customer! Welcome to Rambo's Gun Shop. I am Jean Rambo, the owner. How may I give you assistance?
You need any help?
Help? Rambo does not need help. Rambo is Rambo. He helps himself.
It's so refreshing when the people I'm talking to have voice acting, and I don't have to read it. Your name is Rambo?
Eh? Oui, that is me, Jean Rambo, at your service.
I'm guessing... Is Rambo never spelled on the cover and box of First Blood? I wonder if he doesn't know how to spell the word Rambo. Huh. Let's see what you have. They voice acted the character that's inspired by Rambo, in some weird way. Pseudo-chitin armor. That's 10 armor? Is that what I have right now? That is exactly what I have right now. Requires 7 strength. Might be able to pop one of those on my other character to keep them alive, but right now it would cost me all of my money. So let's maybe avoid that. 7 armor! Let's see, that's better than what you have. Wonder, does anyone have this? You have mobile infantry armor, it's like this, but it's heavy. If I get this on other characters, it'd be really nice. I don't think I've encountered the Spectrum Assault Vest before. 7 armor with no downside. Yeah, no one has that. Everyone has like a 4 or 5. That's some crazy shit. I'm gonna have to get myself some money. Assault rifle, don't use those. Energy ion beamer. That's what I'm using right now. PSG, oh yeah, let's definitely look at sniper rifle upgrades. Wow. There's actually a weapon with higher is it higher damage? It's lower damage, but it's also lower AP cost. So it's higher damage per AP, but I don't know if I could reasonably shoot 3 times per turn, so it may be less damage overall regardless, because right now I can shoot 2x per turn exactly if I stand still. This would allow me to move a little bit, perhaps. I could compare heavy weapons. That one's probably better, but it's not equipped right now, so I can't compare it directly. Spaz 12 is... looks like it's no... yep, it's flat out better than the current shotgun, but shotguns are low priority. I already upgraded the SMG. This character came with an MP5K, and I changed it to an MP5, so his damage has been upgraded, but looks like I could upgrade it again right here with another expensive as hell gun. That would cost me more than I own. Cool. Looks like it's... wow, it's another... it's actually a good amount of damage per AP bonus, too. That's rough. The Wasteland Hawk. Like a Desert Eagle. Oh my goodness. That is so much higher damage that it would help justify that character's existence. And he would stop using 9mm ammo and switch to another ammo type, which would help him not overlap with another character, because my other character already uses 9mm. So that might be a priority to grab that and the sniper rifle, for example. But I need to make some money first, doing some odd jobs and whatnot.
Oui, certainly. Please enjoy Rambo's selection. Adieu, mes amis.
Hey, Eugene.
Freya Thomas,
maybe
bonjour.
So. Let me see what I'm low on.
So they know
been
each other.
Been buying from Rambo since I left the militia.
So Thomas and Rambo know each other. A little bit of a working relationship. Who are you? Another someone else I can't talk to? I guess these are just all the people that are going to flip out and shoot you if you make a mess around here. Alright, I think I'm going to go ahead and cut it here, guys. Thanks for watching, like always. Next episode, we'll probably finish exploring this opening square of Hollywood, and then press on in various directions and see where the story takes us, since we haven't gotten much momentum here. Well, we got some momentum here, in that we got introduced to what might be the climactic fight of the entire game. But other than that, don't know what we're going to do in Hollywood yet. Besides try to take on this God's Militia that's somewhere around here and get ourselves some zeolite. Thanks for watching, like always, guys, and I will see you next time.